Hola chicos, hola chicas. Today we are going to learn 7 really useful verbs to talk about rules in the context of your school life. And something really important is that after all these verbs, you need to use the infinitive. You need to use the verbs ending in R. For example, the first one you will actually learn, tengo que. I have to. Tengo que leer este libro. Actually, este libro. Pedro Páramo from Juan Rulfo from Mexico, one of the most important books in the South American literature. Vamos. The first one is tengo que. Obviously, tengo means I have, and the que, actually means tengo que. Tengo que, I have to. Tengo que, I have to do something. Tengo que. Tengo que hacer los deberes. I have to do my homework. And as you can see, always the verb after all these expressions ends in R. E-R, I-R, or A-R. But always in R. Tengo que hacer los deberes. Muy importante. I have to do the homework. Tengo que repasar mis apuntes. Repasar. To revise. Repasar. And then apuntes. Your notes. Para vuestros exámenes. Tengo que repasar mis apuntes. I have to revise my notes. Sometimes you will find tenemos que. Tenemos que. We have to. So instead of tengo, is tenemos que. We have to respect other people. Tenemos que respetar a los demás. Demás in Spanish means the others. Others people. Other people. Tenemos que estudiar mucho. We have to study a lot. Tenemos que estudiar mucho. And again, always the verb ending in R. Hay que. A really, really important verb in Spanish. Hay que. Now, this is slightly more complicated than others because if you try to translate literally these two words, well, you might get confused. This actually is a verb that is included in a video that I have in this channel with the title of 7 difficult verbs in GCSE. Through every single of these two words, I and K, and I explain you how important it is to learn this properly. I'm going to type I in Spanish and you're going to hear English. And I means there is. And actually, you probably already know this. There is or there are. And if you type K, which is the second word of I, K, is that. There is that. But that doesn't make sense. But if you type IK, look, IK becomes you have to, or you must, or one must. So when they are together, IK actually means you have to do something. You must do something. Example, IK estudiar. You have to study. And the verb in here, as you can see, ends in R. Hay que estudiar español cada día. Hay que estudiar. Remember, don't translate literally. Hay que estudiar. Hay que, you must, or you have to. You must study. Hay que estudiar. Hay que mantener la calma. Remember, don't translate literally I and que, otherwise it wouldn't make sense. Hay que mantener la calma. You must keep calm. And continuar, y continuar, and carry on. Se debe. Number 3, se debe. You must do something. It's similar to hay que. Se debe ser puntual. Must be punctual. Okay? You must be on time. Se debe. Now, no se debe probably is used more widely. No se debe. No se debe. You must not. You must not be rude. No se debe ser grosero. No se debe ser grosero. No se debe con mascar chicle. Now, mascar is chewing, But also in Spanish we say no se debe comer chicle, chewing gum. You must not chew gum. Number four, se puede. Se puede. You are able to do something. You can do something. Se puede. Se puede. Se puede preguntar al profesor. Of course, you are able in the classroom to ask questions to the teacher. Preguntar, to ask. Se puede preguntar al profesor. No se puede, obviously, is the negative. You are not able to do something. You can do something. No se puede comer dulces o caramelos. You can eat sweets and caramelos. Dulces and caramelos, more or less, is sweets in Spanish. Se permite. Now, this one, it basically means you are allowed to do something. Se permite. You are allowed to do something. You're allowed to drink water in the classroom. Se permite beber agua. Se permite probably is more useful in the context of rules. No se permite. No se permite usar el móvil en clase. You are not allowed to use the mobile phone in the classroom. No se permite. But then there's plenty of posters and signs with no se permite in Spanish. No se permite comida. No se permite bebidas alcohólicas. No se permite usar bicicletas. Number six is está prohibido. Literally, it's forbidden. It's banned. You can't do something. It's completely forbidden. For example, está prohibido dañar las instalaciones. It's forbidden to damage the facilities in the school. Está prohibido. Now, again, prohibido, you will find a lot of signs in Spanish-speaking countries. Está prohibido usar móviles. Está prohibido pasar sin casco. As you can see, the sign is really telling you through the picture the meaning. Está prohibido fumar. Está prohibido comer y beber. Está prohibido llevar joyas. To carry jewelry. Llevar joyas. Está prohibido. And the last one is, es obligatorio, like, is compulsory. Es obligatorio llevar uniforme. Is compulsory to wear a uniform in the school. Es obligatorio. With es obligatorio, we can see es obligatorio en las gafas. Es obligatorio llevar mascarillas in the classroom and in the corridors. Es obligatorio seguir las normas de seguridad, to follow the safety measures. Es obligatorio, is compulsory. And the last one is es necesario. And again, is necessary. Es necesario respetar al otro. Is necessary to respect the other.